Quiero tenerte muy cerca y ver tus ojos verte junto a mí. Y es que te vuelves de tierra, porque están lejos, muy lejos de mí.
Desde dejé de ver mucho.
¿Quién es mío? Okay, my little family. Gotta do a sound check before we get to rolling. So, can anybody hear my voice clearly? Let me know. Let me know. All right? Can anyone hear my voice clearly? Just give me a thumbs up and just let me know if you can hear my voice. Let me know if there's any echoing, any distortion in the sound. That's all I need to know. Let me see here. Let me check this here. Somebody will let me know eventually if the sound is jacked up. Let's see here. All right. Sound check, sound check. You can hear me, my king? Thank you, Frank. Thank you very much. is it too loud? Is it distorted? Is it clear? Are you comfortable? I need to know this. Well, you said you could hear me, so I guess I have to take it for that. All right. Thank you, my king. Thank you very much. So, while everybody is folding in, I'm going to play. Now, all these songs that y'all hearing is by Natalie Cole. This was her last album. She did a Spanish album. I think her father did four. So if anybody know anything about me, I'm a big Natalie Cole fan, and I do sing in Spanish, and I don't know what I'm saying. It just sounds good. So anyway, we're going to play the True Royal Family's theme song. And as people fold in, because it ain't quite 5 o'clock California time, we got 3 minutes. So. Anyway, let me get this started with Natalie Cole. Let's see here. Okay, here we go.
Like that.
my day. La última noche que pasé contigo, quiero invitarla, pero no he podido. La última noche que pasé contigo, tengo que olvidarla por mi bien. La última noche que pasé contigo, la quiero guardada como que testigo. Me quiero
How's the royal family? I pray that everyone is doing well. All right, tonight, it's the king's thrones. So the kings will be rendering their voices. I will be hosting. Y'all will set the tone with this angle. All right, Oak Town in the house. That is wonderful. One love, JT Blackness. I pray that you are feeling well, my king. Been going through a lot. And as usual, it was a week full of drama in the royal family. It's always something going on. We were truly built for this. It ain't fun, but we was built for this. So, I pray that the sound is still going smoothly. And I'm going to put this link here in the comment box. Now, it's the kings. It's for the kings. All right. I'm going to set the rules. At Crazy Talk Greasy, I will block your funky ass with the quickness. And then we got people who are part of the royal army. Now, even though those wrenches are blue, that's really a pimp hand. And the pimp hand is real. And we like using it, you know. You know how we feel about them trolls. Hey K, how you doing today? Hey K, did you see that troll video that I made?
I fell asleep this morning, so if I need to watch it early. Was it a comedy one?
Yeah, this shit is hilarious. I was on one.
Yeah, I need to watch that.
Yeah. So what we gonna do? We gonna see how many of our kings gonna roll up in here. If we get enough of them, then I'm gonna have to kindly ask the queens to get off. If not, we're gonna have to do what we did two Fridays ago. Not too many kings got on, and the queens got up in this joint. But we will respectfully allow the kings to lead.
Yep.
Aww. You see that? Wait a minute, let me read something. I'm about to get blocked because I'm so funky. Just call me Funk Town. All right, Funk Town. Oak Town in the house. Go ahead, Key. Okay.
Oh, yeah. You seen that video with that racist ass white cop took three of them sisters to jail cell and that white neighbor shot a little white boy? That shit pissed me off.
Yeah, I see all of that. I see it all. I tell people that I don't ignore those. I do a few police stories.
And I did a video on that shit yesterday. I told black folks, y'all need to stop calling the fucking cops. You doing better getting a pistol on your fucking side.
Yeah, calling the cops is not an option. But anyway.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, right. I think when it comes down to our community, we have to learn to love and trust each other. We got to police. We got to police our own community.
Okay? Yeah.
And things got to be in-house like back in the day. It's got to be in-house now.
No, you know, I made a video about that a while back. I said, when you are around white people, period, just white people, period, you're in danger. You don't know what them people going to do. They savages.
And they show you their true nature, too, who they are, too.
Mm-hmm. And I had a situation just like that. I remember my neighbor come knocking on my door, a big old greasy white boy. And he said that my oldest son had threw some paper down on the stairs and stuff. And I said, what the fuck you coming to my door for? Well, he got to pick it up. I said, he ain't picking up shit. You need to take your ass where you need to go, or you're going to walk up on some problems and stuff. And you know, since that woman went to jail, my attitude on it, she should have just whooped that white man's ass and just went on to jail, and it would have been all balanced out.
She shouldn't even call the police. So she found out that white man choked her son, that's where her and her daughter should just jump on that white dude and let his ass call the fucking cops.
But see, and then I did do a follow-up on it just to see what was going on. And the man who actually choked that child, they ain't did nothing to him. And he still they need to have child protective services over there and everything. That's ridiculous.
Then the cop will tell her, maybe you need to teach your child not to lord her. Then he said, why he can't? She said the man don't have no right to choke her kid. And the cop will talk about why not. I'm like, what you mean why not? You basically saying that this white man has a right to put his hands on my kids?
Yeah, but see, you got like my saying, which we gotta understand what these cops are gangsters. These are slave owners. These are race overseers for centuries and centuries. What makes us think that they're gonna change? They change. They work under white supremacy. They are the modern KKK.
I don't know how many videos that we have to put out on social media, put out on Facebook and stuff like that. Stop calling the police. But see, it's also it's our thinking process too. These people don't think like us, and we keep thinking, some of us, not all, keep thinking, oh, I'm gonna call them. They did wrong to me. They did wrong to my family. I'm going to get justice. They don't look at it like that. Everything, and I know it pisses people off when I say this, everything that they doing at us, everything that they saying to us, this is what they supposed to do because that's what they is. That's what they is. Yasmin, I will make sure I play Cecilia Cruz. I'll make sure that.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the mindset ever since white supremacy has been born.
No, not born. Since the day that they came up out of them damn mountains. That's how I take it. It's all the same.
I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, white folks showing their ass. Ever since Trump got into the White House, white folks been showing their fucking ass. And I'm like, don't let Trump get you fucked up. See, we need to start putting our hands on these white people back. Because calling the police and reporting it is not going to do nothing. They're going to take the white man, white woman side anyway. So our only revenge is to start whooping their fucking ass.
Mm-hmm.
I was on the bus like last week, and it was, and then now you know this old lady, she's about like 90. I said, you go sit down. Oh, but she, you know, I said, no, I'm it's all right. And so this white guy said, "What is she doing?" I honestly, see, not you. I said, "You know what? I don't have no problem with your white ass. You better go on now." It ain't happening like this. You go.
All right. Go ahead. Y'all keep talking. I'm gonna send a link in here because I want the kings to join. Go ahead, Kay.
And then that white bitch put her in that fucking football player and shit, pushed him. He sought that bitch. That bitch hit the table and the fucking floor. Like, because the gay male's too scared to fight that brother. So the white bitch thought, like, you know what? I'm a white woman. See, that's the problem with these white women. They want to scream that they're a woman and sue somebody, knock their ass the fuck out.
Okay,
but you know what? I'm going to fight your brother's not
there. Okay, can I ask your sister a
question? Wait just a second. Wait just a second. I'm trying to do some housekeeping. All you have to do is just click into this link and it'll walk you through to be a part of the chat. Okay? Just click in that link that I put up there. And remember, this tonight is just for the kings only. Even though we got Kay up in the joint and I can't, you know, I can't tell Kay to get off. But if we get...
No.
Just stay right now, Kay. I'm just waiting. We're still waiting for people to peel in. And stuff, okay. But go ahead, keep talking. No. But some people want to know how to get up in here. Just click in that link to say hangout.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
This is what I want to say about that white woman that put her hands on that football player. You know, this is what I'm gonna say. I'm glad I'm starting to see black men knock out these white bitches. Cause for the last couple of years, I've been seeing white men lay their hands on their sisters. And as soon as I see a white bitch or two white bitches get knocked out by a couple of brothers, I don't feel bad no more.
Mm-hmm. But can I ask you a question, Cheetah?
Go ahead.
Why many queens like you don't feel the same way you do? I find, you know why I said, because ever since the incident happened, I remember the incident happened because I seen it. And some of our queens, they be saying, you know, he shouldn't hit her like that. I said, but did you see that he trying to walk away and she assaulted him?
Yes.
They need to look at the old videos of these white men, these white police officers putting their hands on sisters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, I was raised that if you hit a male, he's subject that might hit you back. You know what I'm saying? It's only so many hits that you can take.
And black men, they don't go out their way to pick fights with women and shit, but if you think you a fucking man, be prepared to get knocked the fuck out.
Yeah.
Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Who was that? What's who was that speaking? Who was that speaking?
My dog.
How you doing? How's the king?
What's going on, Queens? Queens of King?
How you doing?
Well, doing fine. So, y'all know this is the king's throne tonight. Y'all can render your voice. Y'all can say whatever y'all want to say. Still waiting for more people to peel in. But I have a request by Yasmin Lewis. And Yasmin made this request 2 weeks ago. And if I don't play this request, I'm going to get in trouble. So I'm going to play this request real quick by Cecilia Cruz. And then we're going to really get it rolling. Okay, and the queens don't feel like y'all have to get off if the king, you know, no. Y'all know y'all gonna, you know, y'all, we gonna always be up in your business. I'm just full of myself today because I've been doing all kind of stuff, and I know some of y'all seen that video. I've been real messy. So anyway, let me play this selection because somebody asked me this. It's about 4 minutes and 27 seconds, and then we're going to get to rolling. All right. So a little bit more music. It's going to be in Spanish. I don't know what they're saying, but I know how to sing it. All right. Here we go. Let's see here. Let's get this volume up. Okay, here we go.
So I'm going to go explain to them what this is. Gift for the fans. Thank you for being so amazing.
Just the ad. Just the commercial. Oh, here we go.
Okay, there you go, Jasmine. Jasmine. Now this is the original version. Oh yeah. Cecilia has passed on. Yes.
Voy pa la rumba,
la lunda, la lunda.
Porque
me cana, me cana, me
cana. Necesito que suene el coro para que se ponga a vacilar. Y te lo digo.
Oye, ¿cómo va? Mi ritmo, bueno, vamos a curar. Oye, ¿cómo va? Mi ritmo, bueno, vamos a
esto se pone caliente, esto se baila apretado, cuatro pasitos para frente, y un meneíto de lado, porque la rumba, tiene la cola, ven la cola, ven la cola, y hay que meterle candela al jarro, para que suene así como va. Te lo repito.
Oye, ¿cómo va? Mi ritmo, bueno, vamos a curar. Oye, ¿cómo va? Mi ritmo, bueno, vamos a curar.
Trying to get up in this joint tonight. All right.
I was jamming to that.
Oh, yeah. That was another queen. Yeah, I miss her too, Yasmin. She was royalty. Yes, she was. All right. Go ahead and render your voices. I'm always running my
Well, peace, family. Peace, everyone. Sister Kimberly Frazier is having a Google chat. I don't think it's on her channel though, because she's hurting her family over the passing of her cousin is just like so not doing the right thing by her.
Yeah, wait. I did a chat with her the other night. Ooh, we had a lot of people in there. We were surprised. I think we had up to like 10 people.
Yeah, I could have stayed, but the hangout was acting up on there. So I think they'd be fucked with minds on there, them devils.
Yeah.
But I had made prior agreement that I wanted to be here and stuff. Okay. So I just let her know, and she understands.
Yeah, I think she was trying to come through. And everything. Let me send this link again. I see Yakuba. I love listening to him talk. We debate from time to time, but it's okay. All right. I'm going to put this link in again. Any other kings can come in here and render their voice. Whatever's on your heart, you can speak on it. You can speak on it.
Yep.
Oh, boy. You can speak on it. So how's everyone doing today or this evening?
Doing good.
Real good.
That's great. All right. Okay, somebody's trying to come through. Let's see here. Let me go over here. Go to my other channel. Okay. Some people are still going to be folding in. So anyway, we were just basically talking about which is on every, I mean, it's no way you can avoid it. You can't avoid these things. The sheer disrespect that we continue to deal with. And a lot of us did get to see the video where the pig did what he did to that sister. And yeah. And I checked on the root. And they had quite a few. They had like 3 or 4 videos on the root where the her, she already has an attorney. Seemed like a very, the brother seemed like he's very seasoned too as well. But anyway, what I was saying is, because I sit back quietly sometimes and just analyze body language, people's mental health, everything. And we're going to have to really, the royal family are going to have to really get it in their head. We're going to have to work out our problems. We cannot call the police. It is utterly dangerous to be around white people. They are extremely dangerous. Check their history. And the thing is, we're trying to reason with people. And you have to remember, that is what we will do. I always think the worst of them. I keep my distance from them and everything. I'm not afraid of them, but I got sense.
I don't even let them in.
Yeah, and the thing is, I had, it's just ironic, like I said, I had that same situation. Well, I didn't, the guy didn't choke my son, but my, he said that my oldest son had threw some trash on the ground in the complex that we lived in, and he came knocking on my door demanding for him to pick it up now. And, he ran up on the wrong person. I had just got off of work, so I still had on my fighting clothes. And I just pretty much let him know what he needed to do before my husband got home, because my husband would have cleaned house. It's a shame that we have to act like that, but we have to do what we have to do to protect ourselves. But even if we have any personal issues in the home front, we need not to call these people. We're going to have to get along. We're going to have to be respectful, but to call the police to deal with our stuff, we will come up dead. That is the only way I can put it. And some of us still not fully getting how these people get out. And like I said, personally, if that man would have choked my 7-year-old child, I would have just took my chances and went to jail and whooped his behind. You're not going to touch my child. You don't choke children. You just don't do that.
And that's the problem with these white folks. They think they can just put their hands on the black folks' kids and not suffer the repercussions. They got black people that'll blow your brains out behind their fucking kids.
Yeah, see, the thing is, we have to understand their mindset. They have had total ownership over our body. So when we were in bondage, whatever they felt like doing with us, sexually, mentally, whatever they did. I mean, I've been reading some real deep history where it was so bad that when the slave master would go out of town or something, his wife would be down there messing with the men, you know, demanding sex. I can't imagine what a man can go. You're already in a bondage and you're demanding sex.
Yeah.
How do you perform? You know, that's the only way I can put it. And so the mindset, him and her were doing God knows what. Some brother has sent me a link today saying, do you know about that white women were doing this and that? And I guess he was new to my channel. And I said, yeah, I know that the number one death other than hanging was white women were killing black children. But he did send me some deeper information. He said, I'm gonna do some research on it. He said that they had even passed a law once slavery was unquote over with, where white women could continue to kill us. And it was how they would let her get away with it. Said, well, she was in such a fit of rage and she's so fragile. You know how they had that period where they would say a white, and they still pull the mess even now, where the white woman is so fragile that, you know, we got to put a law in place because she might subject to kill kids, and they would literally stump children to death. And so
them bitches will kill people,
too. Mm-hmm, they would do that too, but especially the mulatto children. But people have to, people that do swirling. I was reading something that a black guy said that really wigged me out. He said this, he said, I don't see the problem in dating white women because she was just also as a victim too as well when we were enslaved. And they don't see that lets you know they don't know their history. No, you just want to go mess around with them. No, she was fully present, fully active in our demise, in our tyranny. Fully. And we really need to, that's why it's important for us to continue to put this information out, because they trying to do everything they can to stuff our true history. They're trying to change the history books.
And then they because the hands on our kids and verbally abusing our kids and stuff like that. Remind me of the plantation days.
Yeah, but you got to look at their mentality. They want to rain down terror on you. Then they want their legacy to look really wonderful in history. Because you see how these presidents, you see these, somebody call them the founding the baby's daddies, and you can see plenty of programs. They'll do marathons on the History Channel and romanticize these presidents and Benjamin Franklin. But if you find out their real history and how vicious they truly is, those are rapists. I have told the story. Some people are new to my channel that George Washington is my great, 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 how many grandfathers. So when I look at him, I see a rapist. I don't see nothing wonderful or anything like that. It's just really deep to actually see your rapist. Yeah. That's a rapist. And all of those are people are rapists, and they're not. And the thing is, we done got so brainwashed that we're trying to meet their standards. And I was saying this as a teenager, me knowing a little bit of history then, I said, you're trying to meet the standards of people that were kicked out of their country, that were misfits, that were the most disgusting things on the earth. And I would say, think of the worst black white person you ever seen, poor white trash, and they done scraped up a couple of dollars to own four or five of us. Put it like that, and you're trying to meet their standards.
So. Exactly.
So, let me be quiet. It's so depressing.
But the rich white folks, they don't like them poor white trash either. They ain't nothing but they foot soldiers.
Yes, they do their bidding. Oh, yes. They don't mind doing that. So they don't.
And once they find out who Trump is really about, they going to try to assassinate that motherfucker.
But, I'm glad that you said that, Kay. Anybody that's on social media, please be careful. We got white trolls coming to the channel saying, wow, wouldn't it be wonderful if Trump get assassinated? Don't respond back to that. That's a setup. That's a straight setup.
Oh, yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah, they slowly but surely doing it, but they come to us. They always come to the pro-black people. We know, we have sense enough to know. See, this is where you know that they ain't too intelligent. We know that they're listening to us. So why would we be sitting up here plotting the president's demise? Mm-hmm. I mean, these people, I don't get
that would be a perfect setup for them, and they probably could find a black person who's just, you know, like a little bit, not the brain cells ain't firing the right way, and because they mm-hmm. do that every now and then, and then set them up to go at and try to assassinate Trump, and then make it seem like, oh, look at all these black people, we have to lock them up, they're all, you know, they become mm-hmm. terrorists and so on. Because that's their end goal in the matter.
Mm-hmm. That's the level of intelligence that they think we have. That we think we're stupid enough to fall for that shit.
Because imagine when we were under physical slavery, show you the depths and the levels of our intelligence that we changed our diction in the way that we spoke. We even lowered our body so they wouldn't feel inadequate. And we did that just to survive. We know their mentality. But some of us forget in our travels, because it took a lot of insight for us to do what we had to do in order to survive the tyranny that we had to survive dealing with these people. I cannot fully even imagine what we had to deal with, because they had free range. So that's still in their mind. I have free range. I can choke your kid, hit you, rape you, do whatever I feel like I want to do with you, because I'm a savage. You're looking at savages, and they don't care. I don't care how well they speak. I don't care how many colleges and degrees that they went to. I'm going to do them like they do me. I all paint them with the same brush. They all the same.
See, the white man, he may act like a gentleman in public, but behind closed doors, he is a monster and a savage, a rapist and a murderer.
Yeah, they've mm-hmm. just been pretending. That's all.
Imagine if I had a white boyfriend in my fucking house and he just called me all type of nigga bitches and shit. I'm like, oh, hell no, you gotta leave.
Well, we got an example of that a couple of weeks ago. That girl that was swirling, and that guy... that white guy was just cussing her out, and she was just so very calm. And I was thinking, when I was in other relationships, it was only so many.
White boys is fucking crazy, but they ain't gonna say nothing about it.
But I was thinking if she was with a black guy, how many of those she would have been? And I was thinking when I was in other relationships, and I would have, oh Lord, would I fight? It was only so many bitches I was gonna be. It's just my nature. You know what I'm saying? And I was like, wow, you got so much self-control. It's just amazing just to get an insight of that. It really is fascinating.
No white boy wouldn't be calling me no nigga bitch, none of that shit, because I'd have been whooping his ass off through this fucking house. I took a skill to crack that white boy's fucking head.
But see, you got a different mindset, Kay. I'm talking about the ones that swirl and think that they the end all and be all, and they can't do no wrong.
Swirlers excuse that shit. They excuse that behavior. They think it's
wrong. They know them fucking white men fucking crazy. The brothers that be swirling, they know them white bitches are crazy too.
Mm-hmm. What was you saying? I wanted to hear what he had to say.
Oh, I was saying they excuse that shit. They think that shit normal. I think it's normal for them to be N-words and shit. That's why they put up with that shit.
And they're fucking idiots.
Wow. I never looked at it like that. That's...
That's just normal to know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See, we got enough brain and chance to know there's something wrong with that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And the thing is, yeah, something wrong with them, but it's not our duty and our responsibility to fix and repair them, engage them, or whatever. Let them go crazy themselves. Just let them bask in they insanity. See, that's something else we need to do. We need to stay up out of their way, because I see some of them be going nuts in my neighborhood. I don't speak to them. No, not at all.
I even be smiling at me all the time. Every time I step up my house, they be smiling all in my fucking face and stuff. Tell me, oh, I like your hair. You're so pretty. I'm like, yeah, Cracker, I already know I look good. I don't need your compliment. I'd rather my brothers tell me I look good.
White people stay in their own world.
Yeah. At least when a black man tells me that I'm beautiful, it makes me feel good about myself. Then my brother, these things lets me know that my brother still has love for a black woman.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
I don't need no white man telling me I'm good.
But sometimes it doesn't happen that way either. Because I even sometimes I see that they actually white men. It was one time I said, oh, you look so beautiful, black woman. Have a beautiful day. No, fuck you. White guy came to her. Hey, you look so beautiful, queen. Oh, I do. What?
You like? That's how wounded we are. Like,
that's the swellest mind, bro. That's how weak they are in the mind.
No, I'm looking for from my kings. I don't give a fuck about no punk ass cracker. Fuck him.
But see, the thing that we have to do, because I've been lately talking about code of conduct and black love, and I've been doing this for many, many years. If I'm out and about doing what I got to do, I go out of my way to speak to my own folks. I don't care if they homeless or whatever. I will even, if I'm at the store and the line is long at the check stand and I see it's a black person there, I will go over there just so I can exchange that love back and forth. We that's being on code. That's being on code. We have to, we can't, we already know what they're about. We already know what they're about. And we are so wounded that when some of us, because I've seen black men do this, they're not trying to talk under your clothes. Hi, sister, how you doing? What the hell are you talking to me for? You know, rolling your eyes and all that kind of stuff. We didn't got sick sick in the system that we even thinking, even if our own, no hidden agendas, just extending love that, they must be up to something. And that's due to living in this system. And it's our duty and responsibilities to unchange that and stuff. They gonna be what they gonna be. They not gonna never change. So we need to stop talking to their heart. We're trying to talk to a dead, dark heart. And we need to edify each other and exchange back and forth with each other. And that is something that I keep seeing that some of us that get in these situations with these folks is we not fully understanding. They have no empathy for us. They don't give a damn about us. And they feel like they have full range to do whatever they want to do. And they have a system that will back them up on their stuff, because we see them repeatedly in the news, literally, even with their own, they're getting away with full-fledged rape. Slap on the wrist. Yeah.
Get 3 months of probation, but let a black man do some rape, he get like 15 years in prison.
Mm-hmm.
Or falsely accused.
Yeah, but see, the thing is, we've been conditioned, like the queen was saying, especially brothers, to we see each other just randomly on the street to mug one another. Versus, you know, stand the bar out and be like, what's good with you? What's your name? And introduce each other. You know, we so quick to want to fight each other and shoot each other versus, you know, spread love.
Yeah.
You see it everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They want to. I think it was earlier this week, the Radical Home Goddess had did a video and she was showing some pictures of two black guys and they were like in a stance, like they were getting ready to fight. Oh, they love seeing us like that. Oh yeah, they want us to see us doing, not exchanging, like you said, love towards each other. And it's for us to do it. That's part of the code of conduct. We have to do this because we either gonna do it now gracefully or it's going to be literally done by force based on the events that are going on literally in this world, not just America alone.
That's like it's getting worse though, especially in California. Like you go everywhere and like it's like they stare, we mug each other down. It's like, where you from? There versus like what's going on, brother? Why can't we talk? It's always got to be like a I'm mugging you, or we got to fight history type shit. I don't even know where this shit comes from, but like you said,
my husband has told me about that. He's been in a few situations where he says some youngsters have mean mugged them, looked down at them, said things, and he's 61 now, and he said he just know how to get out of those situations. He let the brother feel like he winning. He said one brother even said to him, he called him a whole bunch of N-words. Yeah, yeah. And he had all his boys around him. Get your old ass in your truck. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And my husband was like, it's really sad, but, you know, he's about self-preservation. He said, well, if he was a young man, he would have probably whooped him up, but he didn't got to an age where he understands what's going on, but he knows that he got to get back home to his family too. And he's not going to let just some words get him killed. So I heard him say that before a few times.
I think the whole thing is we need to, like, that's why I'm trying to get classes put in place for us at the school I'm at, so we can sit down and talk and end this shit, man, because it's like, it's ridiculous, man. Like, we can't even go to the gas station, pump your gas without, like, a brother mean mugging you and shit, like, you want to kill you just for pumping your gas. Like, this shit is crazy.
Wow.
You really need to stop that shit, mean mugging people for no reason. I'm like, what you mean mugging me for? I ain't do nothing to you. You black and I'm black, because that cop was to come in that parking lot, the cop will harass both of us because we black.
That's true.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And I think I think the media in this country is conditioning us to be like that. Mm-hmm. We got to be about money. We got to be individual thinking versus
separatists. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Separatists. We're on this separate trip and jealous about what this person have. And that is who they is. They always so competitive. They're never satisfied with what they have or anything like that. I've been around them. I have worked with them where they are working all the overtime, getting buku dollars, never get laid off, and they're never satisfied. I said, wow, these people are tripped. And then we'll start becoming the very thing that we disdain, and we're feeding into that. And see, another part of that too, because I was listening to something that Angel Ramirez said a couple of days ago. He was saying, oh, they want us to have basically what I call that rage within ourselves, where we're just pitting against each other because their plan is not working totally 100%. So it's like, if we can keep enough dissension amongst the royal family, we will kill ourselves. And it's like, they're not dying fast enough because they know what they have done behind the scenes. They know how they have poisoned us. They know all kind of stuff that we don't know about. And they're sitting there like, wow, they really not dying fast enough. And then they're dealing with their own set of issues. So they're going to keep the smoke screen up. But trust and believe, you start doing research and digging and stuff, white folks got some problems. They are dropping literally like flies. Somebody sent me another article yesterday, saying now the middle-aged white people are dropping like flies. I'm like, wow.
Yeah, I heard around 2025 to 2030, they're going to be extinct, or 2050.
Yeah, because my husband said,
middle-aged black woman by then. I'm going to be middle-aged by the time them bitches die off. I'm going to be happy as fuck, too. I was in my 20s, shit.
My husband said to me, he said, well, all we got to do is just stay out of their way and let them do each other in.
You know how many black folks will be happy? The coons will probably cry and shit, but you know how many black men and black women have been through a lot with these white folks? They're like, yeah, ain't no white people around this motherfucker. I don't see one white face out this motherfucker. You might see one or two walking around that motherfucker. They're like, yeah, because once these bitches start dying off, we're going to be taking over this motherfucking country.
White people fear unity amongst color folks, so they do everything they can.
Correct. Okay, now I got a question again. I hope I pronounced it. Yakuba, are you there? You just sitting there quietly.
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes, how you doing?
I'm blessed. I, you know, nothing to really complain about. I'm doing good. How about yourself, y'all? Y'all enjoying the day? Had a good one?
Yeah.
I just had to do something real quick. Glad to hear it. So what are we talking about tonight?
Whatever you want to talk about. It's the King's Throne. I mean, we got some queens up in here, but it's really y'all platform tonight.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
I don't really have any topics.
Any topics? Okay.
JT, you there? Is JT there?
Yes, I am.
Yes, he's there.
Okay.
Yeah, he's there. He is there.
Cool. So what's on your mind, bro? What's any news you want to talk about? I just got back to my computer. I had to do some things. Any current news or topics we want to throw in the air? talk about women or relationships? What are we talking about tonight?
I ran out of shit to say, too. I'm just listening to y'all.
Well, I think
Kimberly
wanted to talk about one thing for us as people that I'm very clear. I was talking about Godson earlier.
Hey, JT, you're going to have to breaking up. You're going to have to come back. You're going to have to re-sign back in because your sound is staticky, is breaking up.
Yeah. I'm doing it now.
It's really statically. Very statically.
Do I sound clear? Am I coming through?
They're very clear.
That's good.
Very
That's
clear.
Awesome. All right. So who are the other brothers on? Is it just me?
No. It's another one here. I don't know if he stepped.
What's going on, everybody?
All right, what's going on, bro? See, I want to. Let's see here. Any relationship topics? Let's keep it something that's involving our people, not so much, you know what I'm saying, the white man. Let's stay away. See, we can stay away from the white man tonight. Let's talk about, you know, something that more involves our people, whether that's relationships or nation building or anything down that avenue.
Wow. All right. That's fine with me.
Okay.
Go ahead, JT.
Nah. I hold that door for a few minutes.
Is there something you want to know about relationships? You brought it up.
Me?
Yeah. Somebody, their background.
No.
Got to put it on mute. Okay.
Well, you know, I usually hear I know a lot of sisters, I hear this topic a lot, how sisters feel like a lot of the men don't date within our nationality.
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. Those are the phones.
So y'all feel like that, like the brothers we date, nothing but white women?
Not all. Oh, that's no. I mean, in my travels, and I'm being on social media and just listening to different brothers' channels. There's a lot of brothers out here that are really into sisters. But if you believe everything that this system puts out, you would think that's all black men are obsessed with is white women.
Yeah,
they would make you think that. Yeah, they would make you think that. And that no.
Can I add, I am firmly convinced that social media is like a bug light. So you get people who they are not finding like-minded individuals in the real world. So they come to social media. So you'll get a platform where they'll get 2,000-3,000 people viewing it. But if you think about it, there's more heroin addicts, meth addicts, crackheads, and all the rest of it. But because they're, you know, they can't put two sentences together, they don't start social media platforms. Otherwise, it'd be a heck of a lot more dysfunctional people like that on here than those who think white people are their rescue. But it's just, there's more of them. But we see them on here because the other ones are very loud. But they're not really, I don't run into brothers and sisters who hate themselves like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me either. I mean, it's just a hand. It's just a handful, and that's it. But for the most part, we're really pushing this agenda about black love. We're screaming it literally. You know, Angel Ramirez made a he did come back. I knew he was coming back to say something. He had a challenge. He did a live hangout where he wanted people who are doing videos or encouraged to do videos about. I think it was. Somebody's got some issues with their sound. It's hurting my ears. Let me pull this up real quick. Because one brother immediately did a video on it. And I can't remember the title. I can't remember the title because I do so many videos. Ugh. I see so many people's videos. So I have to go to my... a news feed, and I will tell you what the title is. And I knew he was, I knew because I've been making videos already that he's going through a like I would call a transformation or going to the next rim. He's realizing Angel Ramirez, because he's realizing, I think what he's realizing is that as far as the negativity part, that there is a, how can I put it? As far as us being negative towards each other, he was really getting on the black men, but not realizing it's back and forth. And he wants to really, I'm total agreement with him. He was saying, everybody out here is promoting their love for their people and their races. We got to get louder, you know? And I wanted to include it also with code of conduct. Yes, black love is real. And then also it's that code of conduct. And the brother, and what he called it was black love, black unity. And Lethal Lady Channel, he had did a, and he always do videos so lovingly towards sisters and stuff, but just showing love for each other, because he's, and it can pull you down if you feed into it. If you read into a lot of that, it can be very depressing. That's why I try my best. Yes. That's why I try my best to stay on a path of people who speak positive about the whole black family unit and stuff. There's different cliques, whatever you want to feed into. If you want to get in that ratchetness, it's there. And I don't even entertain those videos. I don't even watch stuff like that. But I know about it. I'm not ignorant to the fact. And I'm in total agreement that it's like, it's almost like there was two things that was getting on my nerves. Well, it was a couple of things. One of them was what he was saying is like, why we can't celebrate our pride and our love for the royal family. Also, get boggled down. Well, oh, you're of this faith, you're of that faith. I don't want to hear this God stuff. Put this religion stuff to the, and I'm like, wait a minute, no. For me personally, I can't put God over to the corner. I don't even have that kind of power, you know. And I want God fully present in my life, 100%. I need God every millisecond, and I go back to something that the Radical Home Goddess said, and she was right, because I listened to her, and I listened to her over and over, and different people, not just her. And she said something very profound. She said, they know. There's some things that they do know. They want as many of us to go to hell with them, and we feed into that. And I was like, wow, we got to pay attention to what we're doing. So we done got so... so disgusted, some of us is giving up, where we're like, I don't want to hear all that religion stuff. Forget all that praying, because somebody told me, yeah, you're going to be praying forever and all this kind of stuff like that. And I'm like, no, we're going to have to keep doing that and stuff. And then it's ironic, because it's out. It's already out on social media, and I might as well bring it up. So, y'all, some of y'all know that Brother Polite was mugged by the police. They beat up him in one of, they beat up, yeah, listen, let me say something for a minute before you say it. So anyway, they beat up his wife and him. I mean, they just came out of nowhere, beat the living crap out of him, put him in the hospital and everything. And this is the second time that he has encountered the police in 1 week. And so anyway, I was just listening a little bit to what he was talking about. Somebody I don't normally listen to, but I was just curious what was going on. Yeah. So I was just listening to him. And so then I went to his Facebook, and he had put, because, you know, he's a very dramatic brother, and he was letting everybody know what was going on. And rightfully so, he had fear. That's fearful, because he had a gun put to his head by a cop. And so what you so telling I, what let, you me tell- say, let me finish. Ahead. Let me finish, and then you can go ahead. So he said something that was very ironic to me. He puts it in Facebook what had happened, and he says that he wants everybody to pray for him and his family. He what? Said he said he don't believe in God.
Now you're telling me, right?
Black man said money was a religion, the black woman was God.
Hello?
Pray to the black woman is your God.
Okay, let the brother speak for a minute. Let me hear what he got to say.
Now, what I was saying is, you telling me that Black God got beat up? You telling me that his God got beat up in front of, wow, she wasn't able to protect him or nothing?
They gotta stop. You know, yeah, the Black woman is not God.
No, she's not.
I don't know. You need to go pray a little harder to something.
But wait a minute. But I'm confused about something. Some, not all. Some of these guys are saying that they don't believe in God, that the Black woman is God, and then my theory came true. When you are frightened for your life, you can be a staunch atheist, and you can fear for your life, and the first thing you holler out is for God. Mm-hmm. Isn't that ironic? Well, so he wants our prayers.
Yeah.
Ironic. So we don't fully realize. Him, we don't fully. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, I want to hear you.
Oh, the majority of people, because I was paying attention, are not feeling him, which is, you know, people, it's not just that there's a creator. It's that you got to be following the route that he lays out. And he burned his bridge to most of us by some of the things that he said that he has no remorse for. So he calls other people animals. And then, oh, surprise, surprise, you get treated like one. You know? Mm-hmm. What were these police thinking? They might have been listening to your video. And you call them Black men animals, and they're like, well, you know, well, you just said what? And it's like, oh, that only applies to some Black men. No, when you make that broad kind of statement, you're pretty much sanctioning everything that they say against us. So, you know, in the mm-hmm. code of conduct, you may be even angry about something that's going on, but you gotta keep on that path of doing the best that you can. So it's the prayer. The prayer is a wonderful thing. But, I love how you're putting it, Sister Kimberly, that in the moment of crisis, there he is, you know, it's automatic for us. And you could come up with all these intellectual reasons why it doesn't exist. But God, he sets that path. And you're going to follow it even if you think you're not.
This happens to a lot of people of color, though, too, not just male. A female, when they get some money, I think mm-hmm. Stacey Dash did some shit where she was talking about BET need to be canceled or some shit like that. Or
How
are you just gonna get rid of a network that put your ass on and shit?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think Dr. Drake got caught up with the. Them white folks too thinking that because he got some money and he ain't in the hood and shit. Mm-hmm. And they all got his back and shit. Raven Simone be getting her moments too. She be trying to think the white go pan in to the white people thinking they gonna have her back all the damn time. And then she get checked and then she be looking for some help too.
Yeah, and they always want to run back to us.
Yeah.
And stuff. But the thing that people don't realize, it's just ironic that this thing would happen to him. And you're right, because I was reading the comments. Some people didn't care. Some people made videos. Some people said he swindled me out of money. It's all an act, and all this kind of stuff like that. But see, people don't. Some don't even care. It's frightening to me. You fix your mouth to say you don't believe in the Creator. You are putting an energy around you that's very negative.
Yes.
That's true.
Very negative. Yeah, very negative. And then you, and the thing is, I had put out a video about this in August because I had seen what they were doing over there in Sonetta TV, and I picked up on it quickly, and I said, oh, okay, I'm leaving that alone. And the title of it is Gifts from God Are Not to Be Played With. And people can take a gift and use it in a very wicked way. Because I was reading, I didn't know a lot about him until last night. I didn't know that in as young as he is, he done wrote 90 books. So the dude, wait a minute, he's so smart, he wicked. You can be that smart where you're wicked. You get drunk on yourselves. I've been saying this repeatedly. Every empire that dies is because man get drunk on themselves and they start naming themselves gods, even though they don't believe in God, but they have a God complex. Isn't that ironic?
God. Right, man, beat up God. I can't believe it, boy. I ain't got no prayers for him, man. You know, shoot him.
That's what I wanted to say to my friend. All them damn lectures that he was doing, talking about, oh, the black woman's God, money is my religion. Guess what? Your black queen couldn't save you because she was getting hemmed up by the police, too.
Black God.
I mean, I understand nobody will look at property. But don't show your people. Then you're benefiting off your people and shit. And then you're taking pictures with the Kardashians like they love you and shit. As soon as you get your fucking nigga moment and shit, you want to come crying back to us. No, let that bitch ass nigga stay where the fuck he at. I get motherfucking cool when the shit works. As soon as they get around white folks and stuff, they been. As soon as they get harassed by the fucking police and get that nigga moment in the white suburbs, they want to come bring their ass over and start crying. Fuck that shit, bitch ass. Stay where the fuck he at.
I love you, Kay.
It's true. It's true.
It's true.
That's right. It's just, you don't do that. I mean, come on now. Be real. It doesn't matter. You know, we are such a forgiving people. But we gotta stop that.
Now, ain't it though?
Yeah, they're just like rolling over us like it's no consequence whatsoever. So I don't care how many people say that black love, you know, is hateful to others. That's ridiculous. That makes no kind of sense. We just want the world to leave us the heck alone, including those who look like us who don't understand that that's a beautiful thing.
Now, you know? Angel Ramirez, I saw him with his shirt says "Black woman is God now too."
Yes,
I never agree with that.
Yeah.
But you know, I love Angel, but I don't agree with that.
And look. Let me tell you. Hello.
Go ahead, Yakuba.
Let me tell y'all this. That's why I don't get down with that black love and you know people who don't rebuke wickedness that goes on. Like, I don't ever follow a movement where people want to act like everything's all right and they don't ever want to call out the wickedness that's taking place.
Correct.
I cannot get down with that old just talk about the positives, and because that's neglect. And that's not real love, man. Love is conditional. It's not unconditional. Love is conditional.
Yes.
Love comes with, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Things that you can do and things that you cannot do.
Correct. I'm glad that you said that because me being a married woman, I love my husband. I do have conditions. I'm not putting up with his mess. And he let me know he's not putting up with mine. So we have an understanding. We have a mutual understanding. That's right. You know? Yes. Yeah. Yes.
I love that because it is true, because I think we are naturally inclined towards, you know, just the way that the Most High created the earth. And I know folks get all bristled about that, but most of us know that there's a creator. So it's, you got to look what produces more life and more abundantly. And then all the other stuff, you could just sit back and say, having a relationship where half of the relationship, be it the woman or the man, is being oppressed in just that relationship, that's not conducive to life. Having a relationship where you have the same sex partner, that's not conducive to life. You just gotta, you know, it's not, black love is not about just being a sucker. It's not about being a welcome mat to every single nonsense that's out there. It's about building. All life comes from us, or all human life comes from us, and all life comes from the creator. There's no room in there for stuff that's going to destroy.
Correct.
Well,
yeah. Yeah, we can't practice religion the way that this society want us to practice it. They want us to be what like I call it, some people that are Christians, weak-willed Christians, are, you know, just, you're just so modest, and you're just so, you know, you just let everything go. You know, and I just, or you just let anything happen to you. No, you have to do, it's like, and I'm not saying we're animals, but I watch my cats, and if you come up in my cats within their comfort zone, they're going to lash out. They're going to maintain their peace. You're not going to just violate their world. And I feel the same way, just watching that. And that's something that I've been saying for the longest. We always, you know, they all go back and forth with the sexes. Well, the black man did this, and this is why the black community is like this. Well, the black woman, she did this. And I said this, first and foremost, a black man has to stand firm on his position. He really has to. He cannot go along with our crap. And vice versa, we have to do the same thing. We have to set standards. We really have to do, and not just whatever. See, this is what this society want. They want whatever. You can do whatever. And really what this society really wants, they want to, because they're so perverted, they want to have sex with whatever they want to have sex for, the consequences, wherever the chips may fall, just whatever. And we'll just scrape it up and try to put it back together, and you can go back and do whatever. I'm not signing up for that.
They have an advocate named Aleister Crowley, and one of his favorite sayings he said was, "Do as thy wilt
shall be the whole of the law." Yep.
That motherfucking straight evil.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, and you have a lot of and a lot of leaders and a lot of famous people follow that same principle today. Mm-hmm. You know, and honestly, that's Satanism. You know, Satanism is free. Satanism is free and open love. Just come as you are. Do what you want to do. You want to have sex with babies? That's fine. You want to have sex with gorillas? That's cool. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's Satanism. There's no laws. Yeah. There's no consequence. There's no anything.
And they have they're passing laws so they can have sex with animals.
I'm sure.
I mean, I'm like, wow.
These people are sick.
Yes. Yes. When Obama signed into law that in the army, now the soldiers can bring their pets and sleep with them right in their tents.
It's disgusting. What?
Yeah. Wow.
That's lawlessness. That's this great beast, abomination, man, Mystery Babylon. That's where we're at.
Mm-hmm.
It's too many sexual desires. I think a sexual desire should be between a man and a woman, not children and animals and homosexuality and shit. Like, you see, the creator's name is Yahuwah. He didn't create that. He put man and woman together so they can reproduce and build a family and have a good marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You can
The reason why Ashatan, so-called Satan, put all this wicked stuff on here so he could cause chaos. All this stuff is nothing but chaos.
Mm-hmm. That's all it is. And it causes the destruction. Because, you know, it's like, are we living really in a society where you have to explain why you don't have sex with children? That's so easy. But we are. Encouraging people to think that whatever stupid impulse enters your head, you're just supposed to let it go.
Yeah, all is free. Yeah, this just be free with it. And it's
sickening. If I have kids, somebody touch my kids, I let my kids know. I don't care if that pedophile threatened you. If they touch you the wrong way, let me know. So
I know. I told my son when he was real, as soon as he could understand, I was like, if anybody puts their hands on you, if I put my hands on you.
Yeah, I said the same thing. I said
to bite my nose off, anything you can get your teeth around, fight it for all your glory.
I told my children the same thing. I told my children, I said, if I touch you in an inappropriate way, they had the number to my parents. You could let them know that mama done lost her mind. But I wanted to read something real quick. Lion Queen said, and the Radical Home Goddess said, put this up too. They are having 9-year-old transgender children. I blame the sick parents. Yes, they are. She on the National Geographic. They got a little boy sitting up in some spandex and pink. And it's just, it's,
I seen a documentary about that shit before. He wants to be a girl and shit.
What they're doing,
I'm glad I don't got no kids.
They're trying to make everybody in the world agree with white men coming in without an army and using it as their brothel so that they don't have to rape you. You're already ready for them.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
They can't do that to their adults, though. They're trying to get our children. They want our children because they can't get us.
Yeah, I mean, it's basically just the same Greek, you know, Greco-Roman type society. That's just, that's how their nature is, you know. They were always, you know.
Yeah, that's like, was it this year or was it last year they made Bruce Jenner the woman of the year? I said, these people, there's something else.
They ain't talk about Bruce Jenner. They ain't talk about Bruce Jenner no more. And I think a lot of these gays and transgenders and lesbians, they're going to get their fucking nigga moment.
Hey,
Sis K, you're breaking up.
I'm sorry. Can you hear me now?
Yeah. Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, what I was saying was, maybe I was trying to catch up what I was saying. You know, that now that the gays got what they want, they told the black community, now that we got what we want, fuck y'all. But it was their own people putting them out the community when they was fucking gay shit, but that shit came from their ass.
But our stupid people, we so stupid, we want to get up and march with anything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like we just every single movement, our stupid people out there, we got to join up with them. You know, we got to hold hands with the wicked Gentiles and march. And see, that's why we get punished the way we do. Because we will not separate from these people, man. Everything they want to put up there, we feel like we have to get behind. Gay rights, feminism, animal rights, everything that these people do.
You always see some of us.
But I don't want to call us stupid, though, because studying other
the Most
cultures,
High calls us stupid.
We're not alone in trusting devil. We are not. He is beguiling. And he's worked overtime to convince the planet. There are whole nations that treat theirs worse than they treat us. And they go along with it.
I get you. I just look at it like this, man. You know, I've gotten to the point where I just call it as it is, man. Our people, we act stupidly. And even the Most High says that we're stupid children. He calls us stupid. We do stupid things. And yeah, the other nations, true, they've done stupid things too, but it's even worse for us because we're supposed to be the leaders of all these other nations.
Yeah, we're the chosen.
You know what I'm saying? Understand. I just
so that's why it's worse.
If we're thinking, well, we're stupid, because it leads to the kind of people who want to escape the black community, because like, why would I want to be around a bunch of stupid people? So I'm looking at it as when you have a child, the best way you help him to grow is not by telling him you're an idiot. You show him that he can do this. And that's the thing. We're magnificent people. It's just that we've been divorced from the knowledge of what protects a civilization. We have to be reacquainted, but we have to know that we're worth it. That's all. I'm sorry. I love you, brother. I'm just saying that I know when people come to my channel, it's because they feel so soothed. They feel welcome. And then you give them the information.
But I think the ones that participate in those kind of movements where they, like those gay movements and there's people of color that's participating in there, I think they just think it like sense of approval from everybody. They think if they do that, that they're going to be approved. They're going to be, you know, in the in crowd. But
you know why they do that? You know why they do that recruitment process that they're always trying to recruit? Because within their soul, it doesn't feel right within. So you try to find ways to justify it.
Yeah.
You think you have more people that look like you. It may shake that feeling within. Or you'll create so much dissension where you'll say, see, yeah, that's why they're rebelling against us because blah, blah, blah. And I'm going to show them. And, cause it's the stuff we're saying, the city is ridiculous. I want to read something real quick related to this. Organic Dope said there's this website called the New Black World Order. It talks about turning white boys into trannies, white girls into dudes, black men into gays. Y'all all get the time. Peep it out. It's crazy. Wow. See, that's the one thing that I like about us. We need to know. We don't need to feed into it, but we need to know what they out there doing too.
You know, that's true.
We need to continue to separate, but we need to know the madness that's also going out.
I don't think that being ignorant of what these people do is going to strengthen us. Definitely. You are so right, sister.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But don't partake in that stuff. You just know that is out there. Because my husband would say that when we first got married, he kept saying, don't entertain that. We not of this. And I would be like, blah, 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 blah. And he'd be like, let that go. And I'm like, damn, we let everything go. Let that go. I'm like, let that. And over time, I've seen what he was talking about, where what he was basically saying, he was patient with me. He didn't want that in our household. Not saying I would bring that in, but I was just concerning myself with things that too much that was coming into the house, because your sanctuary, your household, supposed to be peaceful. Yeah, you can have knowledge of these type of things, but you don't want to feed into it in such a way where you bring that spirit within your household. When they have to keep it peaceful. Mm-hmm. So thank you for that. Thank you for putting that information out. I always like to read. I don't want to leave people out in the comment box, because y'all always putting stuff out that's very interesting. Because something, she's not here, but she's been trying to tell us this for the longest. Miss Legit, she's been doing some research, and she said that a lot of black folks who are hooking up, that are gay, that are hooking up with white people, they exclusively with white people, are coming up with the strangest diseases.
Right.
And she said, yeah.
Lee Daniels.
You know what? Lee Daniels has children. He has a son and a daughter.
Ooh, yes. Know.
Yes, from a black woman. Yes, they're teenagers, and it's just like
that, you know, that is a lot of homosexuals do that.
But you know what? You can see it over here. There's an energy that's around him. You can see it in his face, a disgust and everything. And I look at him. He ain't happy.
Yeah,
you know, he ain't happy out there doing what he's doing.
Mm-hmm. To have that much contempt for where he comes from, that's an energy that just saps your soul.
Mm-hmm. It does. It truly does.
And he admitted on Don Lemon show that he's a sellout.
Mm-hmm.
Sellout. He said, like, vote me too, like, with no problem. Like, you got to be a sellout.
One true self. Yes, the system does reward black homos, but it's very temporary. It would be on the form of being an addict, okay? And you get some satisfaction, maybe some immediate satisfaction from you, whatever your drug of choice is, but there's going to be some side effects down the road.
You got to look at it like this. Even when the Messiah was tempted, right? Satan came to the Messiah when he was fasting, was like, look, if you bow down and worship me, all you see, you know what I'm saying? I've been given all of this, the nations, all the riches. If you bow down and worship me, all of this shall be yours. So when you look at these people out here doing this wickedness, yeah, they'll have these physical things, you know, they'll get money, you know, wealth and cars and television shows and all that. But see, all that stuff is temporary. That stuff can't give you happiness. That happiness is fake. You know what I'm saying? Because true joy comes from the Most High. So anytime you're out here participating in this wickedness, you know, and people are like, oh, I'm so blessed by God. No, you Satan can bless. Satan blesses all the time.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So
Mayweather's making a spin on the strippers. I heard that nigga ain't happy either.
Mm. Yeah, how can you be? You know, it's a transitory satisfaction on a very low level, and then immediately after that, you the Most High lets you know you just did the wrong thing. So when you indulge your lusts, right after that, you don't, that's why you're like, you know, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, bye. Because you don't want to look at that person. You feel the shame and the nastiness of what you just did. You just basically used the human being like a napkin.
Look at Kanye. Look at Kanye West now. He's a complete, if anybody follows hip hop and remembers what how Kanye West used to be and who he is now, you know, these stars, they talk about how they can't even have mirrors in their home. Because when they look at, because if you know anything about, you know, different, you know, witchcraft or in a demonology, a mirror is like a doorway. You know, you can see demons in mirrors, especially when you're opened up to that level of wickedness that a lot of these cats have been doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot of wickedness that goes on behind closed doors that the general public knows nothing about. You know what I'm saying? You can't be that closely tied to Satan. You know, like, these cats doing some wicked things. Once that door is opened, it's opened. You know what I'm saying? And when these guys are going by their mirrors, like, they're seeing grotesque demons. And they talk about it a lot if you know what to look for. You know, there's different videos where they confess, you know, Madonna, Lady Gaga, and all these people that they can't even have mirrors in their home. They're haunted all the time.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? You know,
wow, that's a world I don't know anything about. I'm learning something every day.
It's something else.
Yeah, but then people glorify them. People glorify them because they'll look at the riches and the glittering lights and all that type of stuff like that and get all captivated up into these people. Now I knew.
That's what selling your soul does. Yeah.
I knew when Kanye West had his fit of rage, and I knew what was going on with him because I could see. I knew exactly what it was. I knew he was demon-possessed. I already knew. I knew what the father was telling me, and I was like, wow, he didn't really got himself in a situation, and he ain't out of it yet, you know? You know, they'll give you some pills and all that kind of stuff, and you're going to, I'm just telling y'all something I know, you're going to have to go do some, when they say purging, some purging, and it ain't, oh, I'm gonna just do it overnight. It's a process. It's a way of life. If you want to get that negative satanic energy away from you, you have to live a certain type of life. You can't say, okay, I got it away from me, now I can go keep doing what I'm doing. You can't do that no more. No, you can't do that no more.
That's right. And the, you know, the longer these individuals are in it, the more and more wickedness that they have to do. And I mean, you can, these people get to a level of wickedness to where, I mean, their whole facial structure, if you look at how they were when they started it and who they are now, it's a completely different change. They look like they're glazed over. And that's because, you know, we're blessed because we have a veil over our eyes to where we don't have to see the spiritual realm. You don't have, you know, we say that, oh, we would love to see angels and oh, I would love, you don't want to see that. We think, you know what I'm saying? We think because of television and all this and that, you know, it's a beautiful thing. And we truly, and it's a blessing that you don't understand what it is to truly see a demon in demonic form. You know, be thankful that you don't have to see what an angel truly looks like. They don't look like, you know, what Hollywood makes them look like with white wings and all this and all that. You know, when you read scripture, it talks about when the angels were truly revealed, people would lose their bowels. You know what I'm saying? Like, they would, you know, it's something. You know, when you see things with your eyes, imagine being able to not just see it with your eyes, but you feel it inside your being. Every ounce of yourself feels that being. It's something that is very hard to explain if you have never had to endure something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But
somewhere in the Bible says no one should see the Father's face and shall live. He was talking to
him. And that's just the Father. Imagine, you know, you can see the angels and people will live, but it's the most frightening thing that you can imagine seeing. You know what I'm saying? Like, you think, you know, these things were killing babies and newborns, and you know what I'm saying? These are creatures of war. And that spiritual realm is something that you should be happy that the veil is over your eyes right now. Because if you had to endure what these people endure, you would understand why they're so nuts, why they're so crazy. Some of these people see the things of nightmares beyond stuff that you can even fathom.
Correct.
Damn.
He's right.
I heard the angels don't look like people anyway.
No, they can see when the Most High wants to send a righteous angel to you, he'll send them to you in the presence of something that you can understand, looking kind and like a man, you know, like a beautiful male or a beautiful whatever. But if you know. There was a story about, I think it was Enoch or somebody prayed to see what the angel, Moses it was, to see what the angel really looked like. Mm-hmm. And I think it was the angel of death, I believe it was, or one of the angels. But he prayed, he asked to see the true form of the angel. And it was the most frightening thing. And he said, you know, he had to beg for the angel to go back to his other form. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, it's something that, we think that we want to see those things, but believe me, it's an experience that you do not want to. It's a scary thing, you know.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
When you were talking about people who are celebrities changing, like their face changing, reminded me of Lil' Kim.
Oh yes.
But there, I think it's more than just, oh, people didn't like her skin tone. I think it's more than that.
She has a high demonic presence in her life. Like I said, when you've gotten into spirituality and a lot of the spiritual things, you can just see it on these people. They just look completely drained of anything that was once human, man. I mean, these guys just look, and that's why people say they've been cloned and all that and this. They just don't look right anymore. You know what I'm saying? It's sad.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Mm-hmm. She's breaking up. I can't even hear what she's saying.
We can't hear you, Kay. Could you come back on in and out? You sound far away.
I'm sorry, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah, what I want to say was, you know, Kanye West, he don't look the same no more. He got his hair all blonde. He looked like he's spaced out high on drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
So, y'all cool. But the question I want to ask, since you're putting this information out, say somebody is listening and they might be encountering something like this. What do they need to do to get away from those demonic spirits?
You know, I would say to get into those scriptures, you know, find out what kind of wickedness that you're doing in your life, or it may be the people that are around you that's bringing it in your life. But you know, I don't know if you may have picked up some type of cursed object or some type of wicked, you know, a lot of these certain you know, in witchcraft and a lot of these different religions, those religious objects, a lot of demons and spirits are closely tied with those objects. So if you have those type of things in your house, those idols, or you need to get those things out of your house. You know, the next thing you need to do is develop a relationship with the Most High and pray and beg that he removes those presence. I know I had to do that. You know, so if you want, I'll go into my story. You know, when I first got into this truth, and I'll tell anybody, when they open that door, that's why I talk about doors. When you open that door, you know, into a new journey of spirituality, with me, it was, you know, reading the scriptures into the Most High. You know, once that door is opened, it's opened, you know, and it's like you can see them and they can see you for the most part. And I think a lot of it also has to do with, you know, I think certain people have different gifts, you know, different things. So certain people are very spiritually inclined on certain things. You know, and I know with me personally, I don't know if any of you guys have ever experienced, you know, they call it sleep paralysis.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Okay. You know, There was this one time that, because I do production, like I used to make beats and this and that, and I had downloaded this. It was like Indian, Native American Indian chants, and I was gonna sample that. I was gonna sample that over some drums that I was working on, right? And I was listening to it and this and that, and then I kind of ended the night. I was like, I don't have time to be doing. And I kind of felt wrong about it anyway, because I know that Native Americans were into a lot of, wickedness. And there was a lot of deities. You know, their music was, a lot of the times it was deity worship, like their chants and stuff like that, right? So I went to sleep. And the next thing I know, it's like a, and that's why I say, it's not just seeing the demon. It's not just seeing it. It's an experience. It's like there's a sharp sound that you hear, and then you feel it. It's like a, it's so hard to explain, but keep it's it, just like keep, the look, worst.
Yakub, let me tell you something. I told you last time, you can have this higher conversation.
But that's the thing is, I can't find the words. I can't find it because it's a spiritual thing. But
I understand. Just know. I totally understand you. Just explain it to the best way that you can. But I all trust right. and believe me, I understand you.
Just know that it's like everything in you feels it.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot even be seeing it, but your inner self will know that it's there. It is so scary, you know what I'm saying? And it's so weird, you know what I'm saying? And you'll be laying in the bed. And you know that when I was talking about that sleep paralysis, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you know that it's in the room. It's like the deepest, darkest thing that I've ever seen before in my life. And mm-hmm. you know what's crazy is that in your mind, you'll think that it's something familiar. Like it'll come to you as something that's familiar to you.
Mm-hmm.
Rather that be a woman or you know, a man, somebody that you're familiar with, and mm-hmm. then you know you'll know that it's not right. You know what I'm saying? You'll know that this shouldn't be in your room. It shouldn't be here. Something's off about this situation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that sharp sound is hard to explain. It's a sharp sound, and it won't go away for a while. You know.
Mm-hmm.
And I just had to rebuke, and I started praying, and when it takes hold over you, you can barely move your mouth. It's the most uncomfortable thing that you can ever experience. You know what I'm saying? And the I think the Most High, because the Most High has always brought me out of that. You know what I'm saying? Yes. And I think a lot of the times he was just waiting on me to really develop that relationship with him. And mm-hmm. after that, I've been able to just rebuke those things, and they go away. But
yeah, you will develop once you have overcame. When they talk overcame, once you have overcame, and the thing that you have to do is you have to stay God focused, or you go with the names. I know you're very diligent about that. I'm trying to tell you something that I know. So once you have overcame that part of it, you will recognize the evilness that may have come upon you. You don't entertain it. You don't feed into it. And like I said, to me, evil is the size of a grain of sand, and then you take that grain of sand and you stomp it and you crush it, and it's smaller than that. So you don't manifest. You can manifest. So what I'm saying to you, Yakuba, I know exactly what you're talking about. I know exactly what, and when this spirit overcomes you, there is nothing that you can do but fully submit to the Most High.
That's right.
And like I said, reach for the Most High. You don't entertain nothing else but the Most High.
That's right. And when she says that there's nothing that you can do, that is true. Your physical body, nothing. There is nothing that, and that's why I say these spirits, these demons, it's a completely different thing. You try to fight that with your physical being, and you will just be ripped apart. You know what I'm saying? It is something mm-hmm. that you cannot, you can lift weights and work out all day long. This it will defeat you if you try to think that you're tough and you're just going to, you know what I'm saying?
But see, the thing is, when you're going, if anybody happened to go through this, when you're going through this process, the thing is, you in your mind, you're trying to fight it. Don't yep. fight it, because that's when your faith has to kick in, and you have to have total faith. I'm telling you, total faith. Stay focused. Most high. Whatever evil is around you, that is going to play itself out. Once, and God will take on that battle, you just focus on our Father. Just stay focused on it. Don't entertain nothing else around you but our Father. So I know what you're going through, okay?
Oh, I'm not going through it anymore.
I know what you have went through. No. I know what you have went through. Excuse me. I said it wrong. No, okay. I said it. I'm connecting with you because I understand the process too.
And that's why, that night I got up and I deleted that crap off my computer. And I prayed, and I asked for forgiveness for even entertaining that wickedness, like I was saying, and even if those things might try to pop up every once in a while, I just rebuke it, and it doesn't have the same type of strength that it used to have. But I'll tell you what, that's why these people Kanye,
one thing you could do. Thing that I wanted to say is, now what I did was in my household is we just cleansed the entire house inside out, just got rid of stuff that didn't make any sense, and you could almost recognize, oh, I don't need that in here no more, let me get rid of that. And and it's just good to just do a inventory in your house and just kind of just cleanse it, and also kind of stay in a state of prayer, and you can feel the weight lifted off your household, lifted off your own spirit. You don't even realize you have a weight on you.
Yeah, I had to anoint my house. Prayed over some olive oil, and I just anointed my house, and that really helped. When I first came into the walk, I thought a lot of that stuff wasn't really true. But I'm telling you, once you open up spiritually, it's weird to try to explain, but it's like doors. Once that door is opened, it's open. And you'll experience things that you've never experienced before.
Yes.
But at the same time, you'll experience a lot of beautiful things, a lot of righteousness, and a lot of, the Most High showing you that He's there, even through all those trying times, because Satan will try you. Mm-hmm. The Most High will let some things happen to you to see where you are, to see where you are in your walk, to see where you are in your strength. You know what I'm saying? But it's never too much to the point where you can't bear. And that's why I say these guys like Kanye and all, they don't have the Most High on their side. They've given themselves up to that wickedness for that fame and fortune and all that and this. You know what I'm saying? So they don't, that's why I fear for them, because not having the Most High and having to deal with that, and I'm pretty sure they have it worse. They get to see the demon for what it truly is. You know what I'm saying? I had to deal with dark shadows and figures that weren't quite right, but they have to deal with the real, and that's why they look pale, they look sick, because it affects you inside.
Yeah, because what they're doing is they're feeding the beast, and the beast never gets full.
Nope.
That's why they look so drained.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Let me see. Let me see. I'm reading the comments in here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One person said, I went to this deliverance church and saw it possess people and learn how wicked people can be and how they send demons after people to kill them. Another person said, yes, curse them. Use foul language at them. Take anything out your house and bless your house. Mop and clean all your walls. And speak to the demon to get the F out of your house. Yes, we had to do that. Yes, we did that. Yes, we did a cleansing. Because my father spoke of this. There were people, my father had an herbal shop, and sometimes people would have demonic spirits in their house. And so what he would tell people to do
is he would say, go to, like, well, we didn't have the dollar store back then, but go to equivalent of a dollar store and get you a mop and a bucket. And he said, get some pine salt. And he said, clean your house with the pine salt, wipe down the walls and floors, but that dirty water, do not pour down your drain. He said, take all the water, the mop, the bucket and all that in the water and throw it, get it away out of your neighborhood and just throw it away somewhere far away. And then he said, come back and get you some holy oil. No, but, well, before the holy oil. Yeah, get some holy oil and have it in your house to bless your house. And then he said, also get some salt and get up early in the morning and go around and say the Lord's Prayer around your house. I remember him saying that distinctly. I remember first time I heard that, I was 16. I never forget that. It was very profound to me.
Yeah, a lot of the elders know some stuff that, you know, a lot mm-hmm. of us, we've been removed from a lot of things. And you know what's funny is when, you know, those crazy Gentiles, and when I say Gentiles, I'm talking about white folks, right? When they mm-hmm. say stuff like, if only I could see these angels, or if only I could see these things and I know it was true. I'm like, man, you don't even know what you're asking for.
They don't know. No, they
like,
sure don't.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you think, you know what I'm saying? They don't even know what they're asking for, man. Mm-hmm. You know, they're just so foolish, man, a foolish people. You don't mm-hmm. even know what you're asking to see. And that's why scripture says in the end times, mm-hmm. man would see things that would make their hair grow instantly white. Could you mm-hmm. imagine something that you would see that would make the hair on your head go instantly white?
I can't imagine. I can't imagine. You know what I'm
saying? My goodness.
No, I can't imagine. I remember heard this story when I was a teenager. There was these white guys, young white guys in a very wealthy neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And they were doing home invasions. And they eventually got caught. And so when they were interrogating them, out of curiosity, they said, well, you know, y'all kept coming back to the same neighborhood, and this one particular house, why y'all didn't do that particular house? And this one guy blurted out, he said, you didn't see them there? And he's like, what? He said, there was these, now he said angels. I don't know I'm just using the word that he said. He said that there was something very tall, very strong around the house. And it just turned out that these people that lived in the house, they were very religious, very good people. Mm-hmm. And they was basically, unquote, prayed up. And they would not enter those people's dwelling. And they could see a force around their house. And they said, uh-uh, not going up in there. I said, wow. I'll never forget that.
That is something else.
That sure is. I'll never forget that. Well, my royal family, we got about 20 minutes. You know, I don't go 5, 6, 7, 8 hours. Because we have our families and we have other things that we have to do.
Yeah, that's
and,
true.
But we're going to always have the King's Throne every other Friday. Also, next Friday, Fukushima Friday, the Red Oklahoma Goddess will have her platform. I don't know what she's going to talk about. I know she's there.
No idea.
We're doing some housekeeping, but we will. I know it's going to be about Fukushima, but she might get into some other things. So I'm just doing a little housekeeping to let folks know that next Friday, you're going to be back on your platform talking about Fukushima. And I have some information I'm going to supply, because what I was going to put that information out about Dr. Glidden, what he had said, but I said, I'll do it the week of,
mm-hmm.
because you're going to be on next Friday to talk about Fukushima. But you know what's been going on my channel?
What?
People been paying attention and sending me information, our own people.
That's good. They've been doing the same to me. I think it's beautiful, because there's no mm-hmm. way that one or two people can get this whole story out there. That's a beautiful thing.
Yes.
Information, whatever, because it's like, what? How can they hide the death of the Pacific Ocean? It's incredible. So folks start researching. That's what I want.
Yeah, that's what I've been encouraging too. Research, research, and people are sending me stuff. And this one sister is sending me something, and she was very angry, and she said, "This has to stop. They can't hide this no more. I'm putting this information out," and it's like the more the merrier, because this is such a big task, and okay. we have to fully realize that when it comes to Black people, when they announce something, it's already been out, and we the last to know. And so. Mm-hmm. Anybody that's familiar with the Radical Home Goddess platform, she talks about many things, but we know that her main platform is Fukushima.
That's right. And anybody something too about that mother who was arrested as you were talking.
Oh yeah.
I can't wait to see that. And so if anybody don't understand about Fukushima, it's about radiation. Oh, and another thing that was fascinating, because I'm glad that I'm talking to you, because you know I'm always doing my research. So it snowed in the Sahara Desert. And the last time that it snowed, check this out. The last time it snowed was 37 years ago. So my dyslexic brain put, I forgot how I Googled that, but it gave me the information that I needed. And so 37 years ago, they had Three Mile Island, and that was the last time it snowed in the Sahara Desert. Mm. It was ironic. And when how you, yes, yes, yes. Because, we know that there's something going on with the weather, because it's all kind of crap going on with the weather. I mean, we got a cold snap here in California. I mean, it gets cold in California, but not that kind of cold. Not that kind of cold. It's freezing. I mean, it is freezing. Cold to us is what, 50 degrees? But when you start talking about 30s, 40s, and 30s, it's like, oh, yeah, that's so, it's California weather. We're used to the 50s in the winter. So, and that's all effect of Fukushima, HAARP, chemtrails, and all the wicked stuff that these people continue to do on the very earth that the Most High made. And that is so disrespectful. Because in my prayers, I pray for the ocean. I pray for the many lakes, oceans, rivers, and streams. And if you just sit and go think about that, who kills an ocean? Who really does that? I had to go sit with that. It literally brought tears to my eyes. And the number one, the number one thing that blew my research on that too, we eat seafood. I've had my share fair of it. I cannot emphasize to y'all, don't eat no damn seafood. It will kill you. It's no good. It is no good. Hi, Jalen. How you doing? Bless Jalen's heart. He said, True Royal Family, they broke a white boy's on these cops. I know, Jalen. I know, it's acting up. I see K. So anyway, we're coming to the end. I got to get my little song ready and stuff. But I love these hangouts. And Yakuba, thank you so much for
hey, thanks for having me.
Feeling comfortable enough. Thank you so much for sharing what you have shared, because I totally understand what you have been through. I've been through the same thing. So,
yeah, it's something else. But does open you. It really does kind of, even though it's a horrifying event, it I think I'm stronger
it's,
for
you
it.
You know now. What? It's like this. I could understand because I can feel you. Anytime somebody been through what he's been through, it's something that you think about, believe it or not, every day.
Yeah.
And the part that I think of even though, yes, it was frightening, the beautiful part was the Most High was fully present. All I had was just have faith.
That's right.
Total faith. Don't entertain nothing else around you, but have that faith. So yeah. I don't want you to feel like you because you can go to different channels and people, oh, I don't want to hear that stuff like that. This channel, you're safe to come here. If you want to talk about that a zillion times, go ahead. All right? Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, yeah. So I know how profound those type of things is. And everything.
One love to everybody. Everybody that's commenting. You know, be safe and folks, man.
Yeah, and I check out your videos. I love that video that you put with me and the Radical Home. You talked about being a Radical Home Goddess. It was less than a minute. And what made me watch it, I could see a football player and he had on a jersey and it had number 17 on it. And I said, okay, I got to watch this video. And he's going, wow. And it was like, it was incredible to watch that video because he was like the Radical Home Goddess. The true royal.
When I see the football sports things, I'm not into it. So
No. My queen, listen to me. It's a picture with the number 17 on it. I said I had to watch it. You know what I'm talking about. Okay. And I said, okay. And it was a message for being you. And it was just so sweet the way he put it because he got such a deep voice. And I was like, wow, this is deep. This is deep.
Okay, I gotta watch that then.
Yeah, I gotta watch your video. So, y'all gotta go watch my video today, my troll video. Oh, it's very enlightening.
He didn't laugh over anything, but he was just like dying.
I did it with a straight face. I was serious.
Y'all, everybody in here on the comments, I love y'all.
We love you too, my king. Thank you, Yakub. I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay.
I love you.
I love you, Kay. I'll call you, Kay. I know you've been on me. Sometimes I keep my phone off. I'd be off in my own world. So, gotta play the theme song. Natalie Cole. It's almost been a year since her passing. Also, Dr. Frances Crusher's Welding as well. I'm going to be doing tributes to them very soon. So let me play that music. Let's see here. There we go.
All right, guys, it's been fun. I'm outie.
Good night.
Good night. Have a good one.
I like it like that.
Que pase contigo, la quiero guardada como un viaje. Doing chores for mom parole? Bounty is more absorbent, so the roll can last 50% longer than the leading ordinary brand. So you get more life per roll. Bounty, the quicker picker upper.
Pensame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Pensame, pensame mucho. Miedo a perderte después.
Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después. Quiero tenerte muy cerca, mirarme en tus ojos, verte junto a ti. Pienso que tal vez mañana aún estaré lejos, muy lejos de ti.
Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez.
Bésame,
bésame, bésame mucho, que tengo miedo a perderte después.
Thank you.